Hello, everybody. Hello, Mervyn, Mr. Wang. This video is a recording of a commissioned project for making a Chinese name seal for Mr. Wang Zhihen. Let me write the Chinese. I mean, the Chinese name in standard calligraphy. In seal, we use the traditional seal script, but when you write, you use using a brush, you write this way. Wang Zhi Hen. This is the standard script, and if you want to see the signature style, okay, or grass styles, you are more cursive. The seal script is a little more pictographic, if you will. But this is already sterilized. And my client has this preference for style. Usually, if you don't really know what to have, I would, show you different styles. But if you want to have specific style, I have some reservation because, like I mentioned last time, someone wanted a rounded seal. I made that exception now, because in most cases that won't work. So I'm not going to do any round seal design anymore. But for other styles we can explore is yin yang combination or just the yin. This is actually my favorite style in Han seal script in negative carving, which is known as four white. You can also reverse it to become four red with thicker stroke. In this case, my client really wants thin lines. And usually we will add a fourth character, in addition to the three characters of the name. It will read the seal of or Wang Zhihen seal. It reads like a circle, or in the first case, it reads from right to left vertically. So two different formats. And we decide on this one with the first name on the left and the last name takes the four right side. But we have to kind of make it even. The principle of calligraphy is to make the space between strokes, especially the horizontal ones, even. Also the vertical ones, if ever possible. Okay, I just wrote this calligraphy. So I'm going to do the transfer of this design onto the stone, and then we'll do the carving. Okay, so I already treated this stone, and if the stone has a sculpture or an animal as like a lion, it has the front side, which is the head facing the user, so it will be like that. Okay, I will use a liquid called acetone, and I have some computer printout from a laser jet. It has to be a tonal cartridge printer or copier. And then I carefully align the design. The design should be a little bit smaller. So we'll make the edge a little soft, kind of like relief carving. And then we use this. Now we got the mirror image. Now we have a mirror image here. This stone is quite big, so I use a large cutting tool. I may enlarge the margin a little bit, so give more space between the stroke and the characters. Leave a little stroke space. Yeah. But it's kind of nice to have some strokes touching the edge. This side is okay. I have a feeling the customer is very neat person, so I want to maybe just cut a line between the characters and the edge out of the way. Oops, that's okay.
That shipping happened.
That's why I make this video. Yeah, we just record some happy accident. Be very careful now, not to cut the corner off.
it's okay to have some chipping, to let the chi coming in, so to speak, and out. So lost and found edges around the border. On the border, you know, with the borders. It's nice. It's not supposed to be mechanical, so it's a little bit chipping, broken, breaking our waving, you know, pressing and lifting with the strokes is what we how we try to achieve a natural, organic, or anti-currentism to make it look like an old antique seal. Usually the border should be thinner or softer than the stroke, or in some cases, very heavy border as an exception. Usually it's softer. Vertical strokes. Mm-hmm.
cut from right to left. That's the left side of the line. But you need to be careful. Usually I cut in between the strokes, so that's where you cut deepest. This stone is quite hard, actually. Different stone. Each stone is different. This is very hard. It's not even, that's the problem. Because when you push hard, it will lose control. So I use my ring finger and the small finger to hold the side of the stone as a break. It's kind of hard. So let me just do it this way. You can also cut it like this, cut down, just without pushing, you cut down little by little, like lots of small cut. That's a different style of a school of engraving.
to light up the detail cutting one to make the strokes really fine. Okay. Just run it in the water, I think. If you wash it, you need to dry thoroughly because the ink paste is oil based. Test print. We need to put a rubber pad under it. You can get on our store, by the way. Or you can use a thin book or magazine. This is my old pad. It's kind of dry, but I like. Give me a very close imprint with dryer ink. You can blow some moisture to make the imprint less grainy. Press hard. And lift gently straight up with your left hand holding the paper. Okay. You can clean the remaining ink with a tissue or soft paper towel. Don't rub it too much, just like make some more stamps, you know. Okay, let me modify this line a little bit. A little more adjustment on the strokes, maybe. my signature on the left side. And the ball and the face of the line facing the user. So that's the orientation. I'm going to make a second imprint. See if it gets better. Ink pad that you get comes with this stir tools. That's what it's used for. So you want to make the ink surface flat or form like a dough shape. In the summer, the ink turns softer. Winter it turns harder. You can keep it in your refrigerator if you want to have it firm. Okay. You don't have to press too hard for thin line imprint. If you press hard, the line will get thicker. So just press evenly, rocking a little bit. Make sure it's even and then lift it carefully. Okay. This side is a little bit too solid. We want to chip it and maybe just randomly like that. You got it too much on the side. I think this side, the right side looks okay. I think that's it. Let me make another one, just for sure. Oops, I got debris on this. Let's compare the design and the outcome. Pretty close. Okay. I'm going to make a few more stamps. My collection. Filled up pretty soon. Okay. From your finder space. Don't forget to check the orientation before you place it on the paper. It'll be too late. Okay, now I'll put a piece of paper to prevent it from smearing the other side. Okay, and I'll make a custom copy. Don't press too hard, just tapping very lightly. Try to get the thin one. You can clean the edge after each stem. Otherwise, it got smearing edge. Oh, I got two layers here. Oh, three. So maybe too hard. You want to put the, because the seal is hard. You want to put some soft. And if you put multiple cardstock, it's too hard. Let's do it again. Okay. Take it easy. Just yeah. That's it. It do have to press a little bit. This will be too light. To press too light. You want to press not too heavy. If you press really hard, it will get thicker imprint. It's not, you know, wrong, but just different. If you want to have it. Thin line, just press gently, evenly. The weight of the stone plus the weight of hand will do it. Just wait a little bit, maybe, and then lift. I still like the solid one better, with more pressure. This is double layer. Okay.
I think that's the max difference. Let me make sure it's single layer. Some moisture from mouth may help. Old trick I learned from the old masters, my teacher. Okay. Thank Mary for your commissioning of doing this personalized name seal, and thank everybody on YouTube. If you have a need for yourself or your loved ones, you can go to the link in the video description to order personalized name seal design and carving. You also have to order a stone from our website. So I know the size and the shape to design. This is a very nice stone, but you can get just a bare rock, I mean stone, without the fancy top. But this one's really nice. Thank Mervin for the commission again. Bye bye now.